An Italian carrier strike group is set to visit the Philippines after participating in the war games in Australia. The Italian aircraft carrier is in northern Australian town of Darwin this week to take part in the pitch black exercise on its first deployment to the Indo-Pacific region. After the drills, it will sail through the South China Sea to the Philippines, where it will carry out humanitarian work. The visit comes amid rising tensions in the South China Sea. Not one, but two brewing storms swirling within the Philippine area of responsibility. State Weather Bureau Pag-asa says both may develop into tropical cyclones. Let's get more details now from a resident meteorologist, Ariel Rojas. He joins us live. Ariel, go ahead.
Good afternoon, Carmina. State Weather Bureau Pag-asa is monitoring not just one, as you mentioned, but two weather disturbances inside the country. The first low-pressure area is over the West Philippine Sea, some 225 kilometers west of Calapan City at 8 this morning. This may form into a tropical cyclone as it moves away from the country and exit the Philippine area of responsibility this weekend. The second LPA formed over the Philippine Sea to the east early morning this Friday and was last spotted 840 kilometers east of eastern Visayas. This is also expected to intensify into a tropical cyclone as it moves northwestward over the Philippine Sea. For now, this system is seen to remain offshore away from the Luzon landmass. However, it will enhance the southwest monsoon or habagat that will dump rains over western Luzon through Thursday next week. The name assignments of Buchoy and Carina will depend on which of the two disturbances will form a storm first while inside the PAR. This Friday, the LPA to the west and the habagat will still bring rains over Mimaropa, Bataan, and western Calabarzon. The LPA to the east, on the other hand, is not directly affecting any part of the country yet. By Saturday, improving conditions over Luzon are expected, but there will still be afternoon thunderstorms over Ilocos Region, Cordillera, Cagayan Valley, Quezon, and Camarines provinces. The weather disturbance to the east, meanwhile, will begin pulling the habagat to western Luzon. It will be rainy beginning Sunday afternoon. But Visayas and Mindanao are also seen to have better conditions this weekend. And here in Metro Manila, afternoon or evening thunderstorms will still be experienced Friday and Saturday, but continuous monsoon rains may begin Sunday afternoon. That's the latest on the weather. This is Ariel Rojas. Stay safe and happy weekend. Back to you, Carmina.
Enjoy your weekend. Ariel Rojas there joining us live. And our very own Dennis Dato for that report on flooding that's happening in Pola in Oriental Mindoro. Dennis, go ahead.
Yes, Carmina, the weather conditions are gradually improving now here in Oriental Mindoro after heavy rainfall yesterday that caused widespread flooding and landslides. Several local government units have also started distributing relief goods to the affected families in the town of Pola, where many houses and rice fields in eight villages are still submerged in floodwaters. Mayor Jennifer Cruz has begun the distribution of relief goods, especially since many residents have lost their livelihoods. According to the latest report from the Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office of PDRRMO, 52 villages from 10 towns in Oriental Mindoro were flooded. Among the towns most affected are Pinamalayan, Socorro, Puerto Galera, Bungabong, San Isidro, Bansud, Pola, Victoria, Baku, and Nauhan. Teams from the local disaster management office are continuously conducting clearing operations on the landslides in the towns of Socorro and Pola. According to the PDRRMO, a total of 5,968 families or 23,096 individuals were affected by the flooding in Oriental Mindoro, with 230 families or 1,090 individuals currently in evacuation centers. The town of Pola is considering declaring a state of calamity. At this time, the floodwaters are gradually receding in many areas in Oriental Mindoro, but there are still some barangays where the floodwater depth remains chest deep. The Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office has not recorded any casualties or injuries in the recent flooding and landslides here in Oriental Mindoro. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Dennis Dato there joining us on the line. Mixed movement in local fuel prices seen next week. The Energy Department expects gasoline prices to remain the same or slightly increase by 20 centavos per liter. Diesel and kerosene, meanwhile, may fall by about 60 centavos per liter. Now, if estimates hold up, this would be the second week of rollbacks for diesel and kerosene following four straight weeks of price hikes.
Kasi po yung mga market participants, yung traders, the importers, the producers, naging maingat sila sa global demand outlook. Kasi yung top importer, yung China, bumagal po yung oil takbo ng ekonomiya niya. So, ibig sabihin, mabagal din ang kanyang oil demand. Tapos ang pangalawa po, sabi nila mukhang gaganda ang oil import, export pala ng Iran. So, merong higher crude flows coming from Iran base dun sa monitoring nila. But, yun nga, sabi mo, nagkaroon ng panibagong direksyon itong Thursday kahapon na trading. Tumaas ang presyo ng crude tsaka finished petroleum products ng around $1 to $2 per barrel dahil bumagsak naman daw ang inventaryo ng United States.